Now, on tonight's Purchase or Pass, we check out a near-million-dollar property and see what it buys and whether we think it would stand up as a great investment. Now, we've got a two-bed, one-bath unit with parking just 200 metres from the action and 7.6 kilometres to the heart of the CBD. It's a large 100-metre designer apartment that's been impeccably renovated. The unit's got two separate entrances and includes level lift access to double security parking. The unit's got views of the beach over the rooftops of the neighbouring buildings, but the main views are from the huge rooftop terrace with barbecue area. There's 29 units in the block and strata fees are $1,560 a quarter. Now, Charles, we'll fire off with you. They've been talking about the million-dollar two-bedder for years, which seems like a ridiculous amount of money, but it's pretty much here now, isn't it?
Yeah, my daughter's out looking for an apartment at the moment, and we were searching different suburbs, and I'll tell you, there are not too many suburbs now, particularly in Sydney, where you can buy anything reasonable for $800 to $1 million. You're really searching out there quite strongly. So this one ticks a lot of boxes in terms of its position, its view, the fact that it's got close to the beach, shopping areas and so on. I know exactly where the property is, but there's something about it that just doesn't quite click for me. The strata fees seem a bit high, but you never know what can happen across the road. I don't know whether there are height restrictions or not in the properties across the road, but that view, the limited view that you have right now, could very, very easily be built out at some time in the future. So.
And that's the hard thing with that view, because what I've always found is it's very hard to actually, if you don't see the view straight away, like it's on the rooftop, do you actually use it? So it's maybe a good time to get you and Jane, is from a marketing perspective and advertising perspective, do you think people will actually hump all their stuff up, kind of all the barbecue gear and the rest of it, to actually use the rooftop?
Look, with a view like that, I can't imagine why people wouldn't make the effort to go upstairs and use the rooftop terrace. From a marketing point of view, The agent's done a really good job showcasing the property, showcasing the view from upstairs, but really when you get down into the lounge room, there isn't a great view to see. The property's been really well presented, it's showcased well, it's in an awesome location, so I think it would definitely attract buyers, but the price might put some people off.
Yeah, you're right. It's an older style block as well, but you know the agent has presented it well, so that's one of the features.
And that's a good thing, because we talk about this a lot of the time, and Tom talks about it. Is the views with some of those pictures? You're just looking at that rooftop, which to me isn't great, but you then see that wonderful Bondi Beach view from the rooftop, and then that's the thing that kind of really clinches it.
It does, but for me it's probably not a purchase, basically because the strata fees seem a bit high for 29 apartments there, and also I'm a bit concerned about what might happen in the future across the road on that one. So it's a yes, but it's a no.
Yeah, what about you, Jane?
It's a yes.
Yes, lovely. And I know you live around the corner, so
I know the neighbourhood pretty well.
Exactly. Well, for me, the unit's certainly an impressive location, being so close to the action. Now, whilst the views from the rooftop are spectacular, I don't think you'll ever really use them, apart from New Year's Eve, unless you're young and fit. So the outlook over the ugly rooftops puts me off too much. So for me, I'm going to pass on that one. Anyway, now it's time to...